Probably heard by now that monkeypox is making news.
Our first report of monkeypox.
Further 14 cases.
In 16 countries, including the UK, Portugal, Germany, Belgium, France, Sweden, and Spain.
Clearly this is a new infectious disease that's spreading in our community that we haven't seen in our communities.
Here we go again. In May 2022, over 100 cases of monkeypox have been reported in at least 12 countries outside of Africa. Monkeypox cases have been known for decades, but infections have been quite rare. So far at least. My name's Gimmons, and today we'll talk about the new monkeypox wave, what we can expect, and whether it's dangerous. It's the year 1958. The American Express card was introduced, scientists studied the newly found DNA, and chicken ramen, the first instant noodles, went on sale in Japan. Some scientists in Denmark identified a new virus in monkeys. They haven't seen something like that before. The monkeys got sick and they recovered quite quickly, but they seemed to develop weird rashes. The Danish scientists gave the virus the name monkeypox virus. Scientists soon realized that monkeypox virus also can infect other mammals, but it would take years until the first human patient was discovered. In 1970, a young girl was admitted to the hospital. She suffered from fever and weird rashes. The doctors conducted a few tests and it revealed that she carried the monkeypox virus. This discovery seemed to be interesting at that time, but not such a big deal, since monkeypox virus had an evil bigger brother. Smallpox is one of the deadliest viruses humankind has ever seen. In the 20th century alone, smallpox is estimated to have killed over 300 million people. For over 200 years, scientists tried to find a way to stop smallpox, and they were so close in finally doing that. They developed effective smallpox vaccines. In the 1970s, last cases of smallpox were recorded. Then in 1980, smallpox was officially declared as eradicated. This alone was great news, and the smallpox vaccine also had a second benefit, as it also gave an 85% protection against monkeypox. This virus, which was already not a big deal, now had to wait. Until unvaccinated people are born. You see, people born in the 1980s and 1990s are generally not vaccinated against smallpox. And well, the reason for that is that smallpox is eradicated, right? This, however, helped the spread of monkeypox over the years. In the course of the 21st century, monkeypox could start to circulate in certain African countries, including the Democratic Republic of Congo or Nigeria. In the Democratic Republic of Congo, monkeypox infections increased 20-fold in the 3 decades after smallpox vanished. In 2017 and 2018, over 122 cases were confirmed in Nigeria, with 7 deaths. Year after year, the number of monkeypox cases increased, up to a few thousand cases in Africa every year. And then monkeypox also reached other countries from time to time. In 2003, monkeypox made its way to the United States when African mammals were shipped into Texas. At that time, monkeypox has been so rare that no one even thought that there might be some contaminated animals shipped into the United States. A total of 47 human cases in 5 states followed. In 2018, 4 cases were detected in the United Kingdom. And these could all be linked to people visiting certain areas in Africa. And then in 2019, 1 case was reported in Singapore. Scientists started to warn that monkeypox virus could spread in the subsequent years to other countries. But the warnings only seemed to be heard within the scientific community. May 2022. COVID-19 measurements relaxed all over the world and people finally could start traveling again. But then people in the United States, Canada, Europe, Australia, and Israel started to exhibit weird rashes. These rashes first appeared in the face and then spread to other parts of the body. All of the patients were put into quarantine and testing revealed that they suffered from monkeypox. Fortunately, all the patients recovered so far. It seems that after years of waiting, monkeypox can now travel to different continents. Monkeypox is a disease which is caused by the monkeypox virus. As we've already said, monkeypox is normally found in rodents and also in monkeys, but it can also be transmitted to humans. Monkeypox normally spreads from close contacts with body fluids, such as saliva from coughing, but also can be found in contaminated meat. When someone has been infected by monkeypox virus, viral particles slowly start to infect cells. The goal of monkeypox virus is to make copies of its genetic information and to assemble new particles. And in the first few days, we might not even realize that something is wrong. But when more and more particles are being produced, the patient enters one of two stages of the infection. In the first phase of a monkeypox infection, the immune system starts to realize that something is wrong and attacks viral particles. Lymph nodes of the patient become swollen and they develop fever or a headache. Then a couple of days later, the patient enters a second stage. Although the immune system tries to destroy the viral particles, they can still spread and cause rashes. The rash normally first appears in the face, but can also spread to different parts of the body. In most cases, however, this process doesn't go on for long. The immune system starts to gain the upper hand and most people recover from monkeypox within 2 to 4 weeks without treatment. Some people, however, are at greater risk to develop more serious forms of monkeypox. DM is a 20-year-old farmer and KL a 4-year-old boy. They both have never met and they come from different regions of the Democratic Republic of Congo. And little did they know that they will share a similar fate. DM and KL both one day woke up with a fever. They started sweating and had a headache. Then a rash developed, first in the face and mouth. In both cases, the rash then started to spread to other parts of the body, including the legs, the arms, and the chest. Both patients were admitted to 2 different hospitals and first tests were conducted. It was clear that there was some form of underlying infections, but the doctors didn't know what actually the culprit was. So the patients both received painkillers and medications to lower the temperature. Experts were called and finally both patients were diagnosed with monkeypox. And while the M symptoms remained the same in the course of the next days, he had fever, swollen lymph nodes and a rash, KL's condition became worse. His rash became painful, especially on his mouth, and he seemed to develop a chronic inflammation. Suddenly there was a risk of serious symptoms including pneumonia, permanent blindness or inflammation of the brain. Then bacteria started to infect the weakened child and caused further damages. In combination with other co-infections, monkeypox can become life-threatening. The doctors tried the best they could, and while DM's symptoms improved after a couple of weeks, they couldn't do anything for KL. Between 1 to 11 of unvaccinated people die from monkeypox depending on the strain. When we talk about these numbers though, it is also important to know that most recorded cases happen in rural areas where there is less access to medical care. But still, monkeypox can be serious in some cases. Currently, there are no commonly available treatments specifically against monkeypox virus, but drugs which work against smallpox and also other antiviral medication can also act against monkeypox. And then there's also a monkeypox-specific drug currently under development called tecovirimat, which has been licensed but it's still not available. So what healthcare workers normally do is that they provide the patient with nutrients and water and try to get the fever down to a normal level. And then hopefully the immune system of the patient does the work on its own. And again, there is no vaccine against the monkeypox virus, but a vaccine against the smallpox virus, which offers an 85% protection since the viruses are very similar to each other. Short answer, no, but we should be careful. Scientists have known this virus for years and years, and now something seems to have changed. For the first time, monkeypox virus is found in people with no clear connection to areas where we find this virus. Out of the 100 patients which have been recorded so far, only one has traveled to one of the regions. This means that the virus could have spread silently and is more widespread than we might think. Then scientists are currently working on deciphering the genetic material of monkeypox. What they see so far is that the strain is highly similar to a strain which is found in Western Africa. This means that this form of monkeypox is likely not a new variant with completely new features. But there is one feature monkeypox virus seems to have acquired. Monkeypox could now be transmitted through sex. Scientists are still not sure what to make of this. It could be, and warning, this is a speculation of mine, that monkeypox might now have a tendency to make rashes near the hips or similar regions. This might only make a mild difference for the evolution of the virus, but it suddenly makes it more infectious during intercourse. What is recommended right now is that if someone has symptoms and someone has these weird rashes, to seek medical care. It is also suggested to be careful, especially if you switch sexual partners from time to time, and scientists still have to find out the link between monkeypox infections and intercourse. Pregnant women, children, and people with weakened immune systems should be careful. And healthcare workers who are in close contact with monkeypox patients should also be careful, and there is some debate whether they should receive the smallpox vaccine. And so far, no one of the patients of this monkeypox wave have died, so that's also important to note. since we all have experienced and still experience COVID-19, and also want to talk about COVID-19 and monkeypox. And what I want to say is that both diseases are not related. Monkeypox is completely different from COVID-19. And this starts with how the genetic information of both viruses is stored and how they behave and how they also can spread. Monkeypox is a DNA virus, which is different from SARS-CoV-2, which is an RNA virus. Having a D instead of R might not sound too important, but it is highly important. DNA viruses copy their genetic information differently than RNA viruses and generally also mutate slower, meaning that the genetic information and new variants are not discovered as often. Then monkeypox also spreads differently than COVID-19. COVID-19 primarily spreads through airborne droplets, which makes it highly infectious. Monkeypox virus, on the other hand, spreads through very close contact or contaminated meat. Scientists now also try to find out whether monkeypox virus can spread through sexual contact, but also this is a very close form of contact. So as it stands, monkeypox virus seems to be not as infectious as COVID-19. But in case if something changes, if there are any new studies, which will now come out very shortly, I will update you on this channel. But for now, I hope that you like this video. And if you just discovered this super interesting and fascinating channel, you might also subscribe and hit the bell button and do all the other great YouTube stuff. And with that, I'll see ya. If you're interested in how we could reverse aging or how oversleeping harms us, you might like these videos.